Dear students, in this class we discuss the most widely used method of estimating structural parameters from reduced form coefficients, namely the two-stage least squares. 2L, in brief, it is written as 2SLS. Two-stage least squares is used to estimate the parameters of an over-identified equation. It can also be used to estimate the parameters of a just-identified equation. In that case, 2SLS will give identical estimates as ILS. So you can use two-stage least squares whether the equation is exactly identified or over-identified. So, and also, to apply the two-stage least squares, there is no need to derive all the reduced form equations. And you need not worry about the correspondence between structural parameters and reduced form coefficients. This method was independently discovered by Henry Thiele and Robert Bassmann. And to explain these methods, we consider an example. An income equation is specified as y1t is equal to beta 10 plus beta 11 y2t plus gamma 11 x1t plus gamma 12 x2t plus u1t. A money supply equation specified as y2t is equal to beta 20 plus beta 21 y1t plus u2t. Now in this specification, y1 is income, y2 is money stock, money supply, x1 is investment, expenditure, x2 is government expenditure, investment expenditure. So we say that income depends on money supply and investment expenditure and government expenditure. Money supply depends on income. So income equation is a hybrid of quantity theory, Keynesian approach to income determination. Income depends on money supply on the one hand and investment and government expenditure on the other hand. And money supply depends on what is known as stock of, depends on the level of income. You need not worry about the theoretical details. We are considering how to estimate an over-identified equation. As you can see, the first equation is not identified because all the variables are present in the first equation. It excludes no variable. And for this case, for identification, it is necessary to exclude only one variable. But the second equation excludes two variables, x1 and x2. So the second equation is over-identified. And as we have seen earlier, if an equation is over-identified, we cannot estimate its parameters using indirect least squares because it will give us two estimates. And we cannot say which estimates is correct. So in this specification, we can estimate the parameters of the money supply equation by using two-stage least squares. Whereas, we cannot estimate the parameters of income equation. In the case of income equation, the only solution is re-specification of the model. Now, the reduced form equations can be written like this. y1t is equal to pi, y1t is equal to pi 0 plus pi 1 x 1t plus pi 2 x 2t plus wt, and y2t is equal to pi 3 plus pi 4 x 1t plus pi 5 x 2t plus vt. To derive the reduced form equations, you have to make all the substitutions. You substitute y2 here, you solve for y1, you will get a y1 as a function of x1 and x2. Again, you substitute y1 in the second equation, you solve for y2, you will get a y2 as a function of x1 and x2. And in the case of two SLS, such a substitutions are not required. I will explain it later. Anyway, if you are interested, you can make all these substitutions so that you can see what is pi 0, what is pi 1, what is pi 2, pi 3, pi 4, and pi 5. That is your interest. For the time being, I am not doing it. So, what I do is, the reduced form equations are this, pi 1, and remember this, in the reduced form equations, all the endogenous variables are functions of predetermined variables. Or in the reduced form equation, each endogenous variable is a function of all the predetermined variables. So the only thing you need to know here is the predetermined variables in the equation, so that you express each endogenous variable as a function of all the predetermined variables. That is the only requirement here. Now the question is, can we apply OLS to estimate the parameters beta 2,0 and beta 2,1 using OLS? The answer is no, because y1 and u2 will be correlated. The answer is no, because y1 and u2 will be correlated. So we cannot apply OLS to estimate the parameters, because expected y1 u2 is not equal to 0. This point we have discussed earlier. Now suppose that we find a proxy for y1 such that, although resembling y1, that is, although highly correlated with y1, not uncorrelated with u. Suppose that we identify a proxy for y1 such that, although highly correlated with y1, not correlated with u2. Such a proxy is known as instrumental variable, IV. Such a proxy is known as instrumental variable, IV. Now, if we can find such a proxy, OLS can be applied to the money supply equation to estimate beta 2,0 and beta 2,1. We have introduced IV in the context of autoregressive and distributed lag models. We will study instrumental variables in detail at a later time, because it has been observed by the econometricians that correlation between explanatory variables and stochastic disturbances are highly prevalent in the real world. So that instrumental variable method is a method of estimation like OLS, like maximum likelihood, and it is extensively used nowadays, that we will discuss in detail at a later time. So the point is, if we can find out such a proxy, then we can estimate the parameters of the money supply equation. Now the question is, how does we find out such an instrumental variable, a proxy? The use of proxy is not correct, that also we will discuss later. Now, the answer, how to find out the proxy for Y2 is given by Thiel and Bassmann. So, this is the method is what we are going to explain. Remember this, the method is known as 2SLS, two stage least squares. So as the name implies, this is nothing but OLS applied in two stages. OLS applied in two stages. Let us see what is stage one. Stage one. In the first stage, to get rid of the likely correlation between Y1 and U2, we regress Y1 on all the predetermined variables in the entire model, in the entire system, to get rid of the likely correlation between Y1 and U2, we regress Y1 on all the predetermined variables on the system. That will give us Y1t as equal to pi hat 0 plus pi hat 1 x 1t plus pi hat 2 x 2t plus u hat t. Actually, I write a wt here, but such a substitution is not required here. I just write it as pi hat 0, pi hat 1, etc. These pi hats are not obtained by substitution. We simply regress y1 on x1 and x2, the predetermined variables, from which you will get y hat 1t as equal to pi hat 0 plus pi hat 1 x 1t plus pi hat 2 x 2t. Or we can write it as y 1t as equal to y hat 1t plus u hat t. We write it as y 1t is equal to y hat 1t plus u hat t. So you will get y1t as equal to y hat 1t and u hat t. And you can see this y hat 1t is this. This is y hat 1t. And as you can see, now y1t is decomposed into two parts. One is y hat 1t, the other one is u hat t. And y hat 1t is a linear combination of the non-stochastic x1 and x2 with the pi hat 0, pi hat 1 and pi hat 2 serving as the weights. As y hat 1t is a linear combination of non-stochastic x, it will be uncorrelated with the u2. The second part is u hat t, the random component. So y hat 1t, linear combination of non-stochastic x, then u hat t, the random component. Now, this is the first step. In the first step, y1t is regressed on all the predetermined variables. In the second stage, stage 2, what we do is, we replace y1t with what is known as y hat 1t. So that we write y2t as equal to beta 20 plus beta 21. y1t is y hat 1t plus u hat t plus u2t. I write this as beta 20 plus beta 21 y hat 1t plus beta 21 u hat t plus u2t, so that y2t is equal to beta 20 plus beta 21 y hat 1t plus U start. So Y to T is in the second stage, we regress Y to T on Y hat 1T. That is, in the second stage, Y1 is replaced by Y hat 1. And this Y hat 1 will be uncorrelated with U star. So we can apply OLS to this. So in the second stage, we apply OLS to this, we obtain the estimates beta 20 and beta 21. So remember this, the 2SLS is nothing but OLS applied in two stages. OLS applied in two stages. In the first stage, the endogenous explanatory variable is regressed on all the predetermined variables, obtain its estimate. In the second stage, this estimate is replaced in the original equation. You will get beta 20 and beta 21. These are the two stage least squares estimators. That is, if you give hats, two stage least squares estimators. Now it can be shown that although Y1 in the original equation is correlated with the U2, Y hat 1 in the new equation is uncorrelated with the U star. So that we can apply OLS to this equation, which give us consistent estimates. Consistent estimates. Remember this. 2SLS estimators are only consistent. The small sample properties will not be satisfied. There is one reason for that. Consider this Y hat 1. It is a linear combination of X1 and X2. But this X1 and X2 are weighted by estimators, and estimators are random variables. And as we have suggested earlier, these estimators, pi hats, will be functions of U. While discussing normality assumption, we have shown that estimators are ultimately functions of the error term. That is why we assume that U is normally distributed. Then estimators will also be normally distributed. Here also, the estimators are functions of U. So that in small samples, there will be some correlation between the estimators and U. So that in small samples, as Y hat is a linear combination with the estimators serving as the weights, there will be some correlation between Y hat and U star. Y hat and U star. But this correlation will disappear as the sample size increases indefinitely. So we will say that the 2SLS estimators become consistent. So in the case of 2SLS, estimators are consistent, not a minimum variance, unbiased, efficient, etc. Small sample properties will not be satisfied. So consistency is enough. In large samples, we examine what happens to the distribution of the estimator as sample size increases indefinitely. So this is what is known as 2SLS. To further explain 2SLS, let us expand this two equation system, modify this. Let me expand this system like this. Let Y1T is equal to beta 10 plus beta 12 Y2T plus gamma 11 X1T plus gamma 12 X2T plus U1T. And Y2T is equal to beta 20 plus beta 21 Y1T plus gamma 23 X3T plus gamma 2 for x 4t plus u 2t. As usual, x1, x2, x3 and x4 are predetermined variables, y1 and y2 are endogenous. And as you can see, both equation excludes two variables. First equation excludes x1 and x3 and x4. Second equation excludes x1 and x2. For just identification, an equation need to be exclude only one variable. As more than one variable is excluded, both equations are over-identified. So, we cannot apply ILS, we apply two SLS. So, in the first step, we regress each endogenous variable on all the predetermined variables so that y1t is equal to for notational convenience, I write it as pi hat 0 plus pi hat 1 x1t plus pi hat 2 x2t plus pi hat 3 x3t plus pi hat 4 x4t plus wt, say. And from this, you will get y1t as equal to y hat 1t plus w hat t. y1t as equal to y hat 1t plus w hat t. Or we can say, there is no need for writing this, u hat 1t. So you will get it as u hat 1t. Then in the second, y2t is equal to pi hat 5 plus pi hat 6 x1t plus pi hat 7 x2t plus pi hat 8 x3t plus pi hat 9 x4t plus u hat 2t, so that y2t is equal to y hat 2t plus u hat 2t. So you decompose y1 into y hat 1 and u hat 1, y2 into y hat 2 and u hat 2. So in the second stage, what we do is we regress y1t. In the second stage, what we do is y1t is equal to beta 10 plus beta 1 2 y hat 2 t plus gamma 1 1 x 1 t plus gamma 1 2 x 2 t plus u star 1 t. U star 1 t is, this quantity is y2t is replaced by this, so you will get it as beta 1 2 u hat 1 t plus u 1 t, that is u star 1 t. Similarly, y2t is equal to beta 20 plus beta 21 y hat 1 t plus gamma 2 3 x 3 t plus gamma 2 4 x 4 t plus u star 2 t. That is, y2 is replaced by y hat 2, y1 is replaced by y hat 1. And the disturbance terms as usual. So, this will give us estimates of all the structural parameters. Remember this, in the case of 2SLS, there is no need for making all the substitutions to derive at the reduced form coefficients, because we are estimating the structural parameters directly in the second stage. So what is required is a knowledge of all the exogenous variables in the model, so that in the first stage, each endogenous variable is regressed on all the exogenous variables, obtain its estimators, and in the second stage, these estimators are used to substitute the original y, original endogenous variables. And y hat is known as y hat 1, y hat 2, etc. are known as instrumental variables for y1, y2, etc. Now this is the procedure. Now let me just explain a few features of 2SMS. A few features of 2SMS. One is, it is a single equation method. It is a single equation method. So it is very easy to apply. It is an economic way of estimating the parameters of a structural equation model, because it is a single equation model, not a, or a limited information method, not a system method. Now, unlike ILS, it will give only a single estimate of the parameters. If you apply ILS in the context of over-identified equations, you will get a multiple estimates. But in the case of 2SLS, for each structural parameter, you will get only one estimate. And it is easy to apply. Especially if you have a large simultaneous equation model, the only thing you should know is the predetermined variables in the model. So it is easy to apply. A fourth one is, and one more point is, if we apply 2SLS to estimate the parameters of a just identified equation, 2SLS is equal to ILS. Both will give identical estimates. So whether the equation is exactly identified or just identified, it is more convenient to use 2SLS. And remember this, we can apply 2SLS whether the equation is just identified or over-identified. A fifth point is, if R square from the first regression, R square from the first regression means in the first stage, that is endogenous variable regressed on predetermined variables, is very high, so in excess of 0.8, then 2SLS and OLS will be almost identical. 2SLS and OLS will be almost identical. The reason is that R square is a measure of goodness of it. And R square measures the proportion of variation in Y explained by X. If 80% or more than 80% of the variation in Y is explained by Xs, then the unexplained portion is very low. That means this Y hat is almost a linear combination of Xs. So if R square is in excess of 0.8, 2SLS and OLS will give identical results. If R square is very low, then if R square is very low, then 2SLS is meaningless. That means non-stochastic excess cannot explain any variation in Y. So it cannot be applied. So remember these points. And one more point. In almost all the softwares, you have an option to estimate 2SLS. It is given as instrumental variable. So it is very easy to apply. You have a dialog box to specify the equation, another dialog box to specify the instrumental variables, and you can estimate the coefficients easily. So the only thing is, you must know how to specify 2SLS, etc. And also remember these points about 2SLS. Easy to apply, single equation, give only one estimate, then 2SLS will give ILS if exactly identified, and it is meaningful if and only if R square in the first stage is very high. It is not meaningful if R square from the first stage is low. And you consult any book on econometrics to see how examples are worked out using 2SMS.